Hey guys, today I'm going to be updating you about my second tightening that I had done. And I think it's already been like 3 months since I first got my braces on, so it's pretty crazy how it's just kind of flying by. This time when I went in there, I see the orthodontist. He sees me for like 5 minutes, and then I go see one of the tech people and they do whatever is on my chart that he has assigned them to do. So when I went in to see him, he had said that this time we were going to put the stainless steel wires on. And so I was really nervous about that, and he was like, and we're going to try to close up some of them spaces and put a power chain on. So I was like thinking, God, like I thought it would be at least a couple more times from now. But I went back there and they put the stainless steel wire on, and I thought they had already put the power chains on because like automatically you feel a little bit more pressure. It's not nothing painful, but you just feel a little more pressure. And so then she puts the power chain on, and what it is a rubber band just like you get around your brackets, except they're connected. So it's four in my case, and they're all connected. And she starts from one side and pulls it all the way to this side. And I guess I'll kind of show you where you can see what I'm talking about. And I chose teal, and if I'd have known it would have been so much more like stand out of a color, since it's so much thicker, I probably wouldn't have chose teal because it kind of looks green now, and I feel like weird wearing pink or something that doesn't match it. So I wish I'd have got a color that was a little bit more less noticeable, but it's okay. This is kind of how it goes. It goes from this right here all the way to right here, and then down here to here. And if you notice, I have like larger gaps right here. So that's just kind of what they said would happen, and then they would connect them all, just kind of keep going from there. And it didn't really hurt really bad. I was able to go to eat afterwards, but then that night the pain kind of started to kick in. I wouldn't say pain, just really uncomfortable, not pain. And I took ibuprofen, so that was okay. But just a lot of pressure. It kind of feels like when you eat something cold, how it's like a little sensitive. That's how they felt. And this was crazy. My appointment was at 2:20, and by 9 o'clock, you could already see crazy difference between the gaps in my teeth. So by the time I went to bed at like 2 or 3 in the morning, my teeth looked like they do now, which, like, you remember how big the gaps were in between my teeth, and look now. It's like almost closed right here, and then this side is like pretty much all closed, and then I still have like a little bit of gaps right here. So I mean, this is crazy. I'm only had it for 2 days now. I haven't seen any progress today, but yesterday it was just crazy how much changes happen within hours. So I was really excited about that. She said some people see, you know, their gaps all closed by in the morning, and some people it takes a little bit of time. So I'm really excited to finally see change. And you know how they messed up one of my tooth and made it like taller than the other? They fixed that at the same time. So now it's like completely flat across, which I'm really excited about that too. So now I'm starting to finally see positive changes, and it's getting really, really exciting. I don't have any pain or anything today. Yesterday, what I did notice, which I thought was a little strange, is that I guess because it has to do with your teeth and the roots of your teeth, but like my vision was really weird. Like it felt as if you had crossed your eyes for a really long time and then uncrossed them. You know how you feel like that pressure in your eyes? That's how mine felt all day yesterday. So I took ibuprofen, and once it kicked in, it would go away. But I thought that was really weird. I know someone who had a palate expander, and her orthodontist said that you would feel pressure in your head, so maybe that was something to do with it. So I have another appointment for another 6 weeks from now, and I guess they'll be either taking these off and then just closing up the spaces around here, or they just keep it on and add to it. But the only regret probably is getting teal. I wish that I would have got like purple or something, anything like a lighter color. But I didn't. I mean, because I think it looks fine like on these teeth. It's just so thick right here where they have it. But that's okay. I guess I can deal with it for now, but I'm just really happy that they're starting to like all close up. I know that in like 2 months I'm gonna be like, okay, good enough for me, take these things off. But so far they've been good. Something that's still bothering me is there's one spot on the inside of my lip that just this corner just keeps rubbing on. Like I actually had to wear wax the other night to bed, so I don't know why. For some reason it's just rubbing in that one spot, but there's nothing really that you can do about it except put wax on there. So I guess that's it. I just wanted to update y'all and kind of tell you what was going on since I'd had it changed. And the crazy, crazy dramatic results that I had within hours was really cool to see. So if you have any questions, just let me know. Don't forget to subscribe. And I also have a cool video coming up about how to get free makeup. So don't forget to check that out. Bye, guys.